right. Steve's first time of an echinoid sea urchin.
All right, age five. Well, it was true, actually. I lived then just on the outskirts of Bournemouth, and that was in Hampshire originally. And one of my passions, I know it's actually cheaper, was we had a rough old garden. So I used to dig holes in the garden looking for stuff, and that's what I dug this hole. And I thought it was a little bead, so I sort of picked it up, and then I cleaned it up and looked down and thought, that's a really strange little bead, beautiful pattern on it, and that, and it looked like a little stem on it. To check it was a bead, or whatever. Of course, you put in those days, everything you sort of check, I used to do with mouth, and I bit it, and I thought, no, that's stone, it's not sort of thing. So I knew it was a fossil, but I didn't know what, and I still really don't know, actually. It's an echinoid, I think, but I've never seen one quite like it, so that's quite interesting. And the only way I kept it, really, because in those days, I have a family of five, so my mother, in those days, would not like now, you just go down to B&Q or not whatever, where you go shopping and buy new stuff when it gets worn out. In those days, everything was replaced. So she'd have a big box like this with buttons in, you know, keep replacing the button and we'd all lose. So it stayed in the button box, I suppose, for years, because of course in those days, we used to swap stuff. We never had money to buy stuff, so we used to swap stuff. And it probably would have got lost. So I think when I restarted sort of fossil collecting again, I said to my mother, I said, have you still got that echinoid thing? She said, yeah, I think I have to. Still have this button box and found the thing, and there it is. So that was the initial start. So that set an interest, I guess. But it certainly didn't, it developed from that, but I never carried on fossil collecting until I got back into when I was about 12, and then carried on fossil collecting there, but again, couldn't do it properly. So that diminished because other interests took over. Like in those days, we'd go collecting birds' eggs, shooting, fishing, all that sort of thing. So I only revisited fossil collecting when I was about 32.